So in this video, we are going to discuss about constructors in C++. Okay, so here you can see some of the definitions or informations about constructors. Process of creating and deleting objects in C++ is a vital task. Yes. Then, if you are creating an object of the class, automatically this constructor method will be called. Constructor is a special member function inside the class. Okay, so why this constructor is required? So if you want to initialize the object of the particular class, the constructors can be used. So when this constructor will be called, example, constructors get invoked whenever an object of its associated class is created. So inside the class, if you are creating a particular object inside the class, automatically this constructor method will be called immediately. Okay, so then, so initial values can be passed as arguments. Yes, this is one of the advantage related to constructor. Then you can call this constructor in two ways. One is explicitly and implicitly you can call this constructor. Another points related to this constructor is, you should remember that, so declare in public section. Okay, so the constructor should be declared in the public section of the class. So it should be a public member function. Okay, then this constructor don't have any return type, even void return type also not there, you should not give. So they get automatically invoked when the objects are created. This is another point. Like other functions, they can have default arguments. Yes, you can pass the arguments and you can use that, those arguments can be accessed inside the particular function, member function. Then, so the inheritance cannot be applicable for this particular member function, but in all other member functions you can use, but constructors won't accept, or you can't use inheritance in this constructor, that is member function. Okay, so then these are the four different types of constructors available in general. So one is the do nothing constructor, and second one is the default constructor, third one is the parameterized constructor, and the fourth one is copy constructor. So we'll go to the Xcode editor, so we'll see one by one with the example. So there are four types of constructors we have discussed. One is do nothing constructor, and second one is a default constructor, and third one is the parameterized constructor, and fourth one is the copy constructor. So first we will see that do nothing constructor. Here for that I need to use the keyword public. Okay, so because the constructor need to be declared under the public. Okay, so pub public, then the constructor name is constructor. Okay, so I have created the constructor method, and here I need to create one object here. So constructor is a class name. Okay, so after that object name is obj1, I have created the object. Now we will see that whether this do nothing constructor will work or not. Okay, so its build succeeded. Yes, so we'll see that, but yes, it's executed without any error, but we need to see that whether this constructor method has been called or not. So for that, what I'm going to do it, I'm going to add one particular print statement here, cout. Default constructor, then, okay. So we'll see that if this print statement is printed here in the output, automatically it means that while I'm creating this object, this particular constructor has been called. Okay, so we'll see that. Yes, see, now the print statement has been worked. So while I'm creating this object, this particular constructor has been called. So this is called a do nothing constructor. This with a just in the structure has been added with this member function, has been added with this class. So this is called do nothing constructor. But if I want to use the default constructor that has been used to define the values for the particular variable. Say example, if I'm declaring a variable A and B, right? So two variables I'm declaring. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this particular constructor to define these two variables. Say example, A C equal to 10, okay? So then B C equal to 20, okay? So here I'm initializing these two variables. Now I need to know that, so this has been initialized or not, okay? So for that, I'm going to create one more member function called void display, right? That's all. So this member function is going to display these two variables. So cout value of A, okay, then A and L. Okay, now this statement will print the value of A, then cout value of B, then okay, B, then and L. Okay, so now these two statements will give the value of A and B. Okay, so for that I need to, anyway, with this, while I'm creating this object, automatically this constructor will be called, but this I need to call this particular member function. So object one dot display. Okay, so now this member function will be called. So now this is called default constructor. Okay, so we'll run this, so we'll see what kind of output we are able to get it. Yes, so now here while I'm creating this object, this default constructor is called, same time it's initializing the values values of A and B, and same time I'm using one particular member function to display these two variables, right? So this is called default constructor. So here we are going to see that parameterized constructor. Okay, so in the parameterized constructor, what we are going to do it, so here I have again declared one do nothing constructor. Okay, so but here I'm going to declare a parameterized constructor. So parameterized constructor, what I need to do it, I'm going to declare two variables. One is int c, int d. Okay, so two variables I have declared. So with this we are going to pass the parameters, right? Parameter values we are going to pass it. Then here, how can I pass the values to this particular constructor to initialize A C equal to C, right? Then B C equal to D. Okay, so now with this values parameters, I'm going to initialize A and B. So for that I need to pass the values to these parameters, right? So for that, what I'm going to do it, so I'm going to call the constructor. How I'm going to call the constructor? Constructor, okay, then object name to, then I'm going to pass the values. So 11 comma 22. Now these two values will be passed to the parameters, these parameters. Okay, so what is the idea behind this? First one, while you're creating the object, the constructor will be called. Yes, this is the do nothing constructor. Which, how it will be called? While you are creating the first object, this constructor will be called, right? But this constructor won't be called because this is a parameterized constructor. So I'm creating the second object with the values. So while I'm creating this object, automatically this parameterized constructor will be called. Okay, so now I'm going to check that whether this value has been assigned to this A and B or not. Okay, for that what I'm going to do it, object to dot display. That's all. So the display member function will display what is the value of A and B. Now we'll verify whether this will executes properly or not. Okay. Yes, see here, while I'm creating this second object, the parameterized constructor will be called. If you want to check what is the A and B value for object 1, if you want to check, yes, you can check it. So, what I am going to do it, object 1, right, that's all. Okay, so for this what I'm going to do it, object 1 dot display. Okay, so we'll see now for object 2 dot display and object 1 dot display. So what are the values for A and B? Build succeeded. See here, this is the value for object 2 and these are the values of object 1. Okay, so this is how your parameterized constructor will work. Now if you want to use the copy constructor, how it will work? No problem. So we can do that. So what is the only thing I need to do it? I'm going to do it one more object, right? I'm going to create one more object. See, constructor object 3, that's all, right? Now object 3 is equal to object 2. This is called copy constructor. So if I'm calling object 3 dot display, right, so what will come? Okay, we'll see that. So I'm just hiding object, then I need to verify whether which A and value. Now here I am just changing into object 3. Okay, so now we'll check it. See, first one is, this is for object 2 and this is for object 3. So with the copy constructor, what I can do it, I can initialize the values of A and B. Same time I can use the same constructor I can call during the object creation. Is it right? Okay, so these are the four different constructors. One is a do nothing constructor, and second one is the default constructor, and third one is the parameterized constructor, and the fourth one is copy constructor.